friends, and thank you for that warm welcome. Always appreciate it. Well, today, this is the video that starts it all. This is the video that at the end of the video, of each video, now we are going to be offering a cash prize to the winner who can identify what is wrong with this here photograph, all right there. So you have to watch the end of the video to so you can see how to win your $20 prize, all right there, friends? Okay. So, this video is going to be showing you exactly how Apollo was faked, and that there was not one astronaut, there was not two astronauts, but there were three astronauts on Apollo 12, and I'm going to prove it to you. All right there, friends? Okay, so let's get on with it now and have Mr. Expat Taffy come on and give you some good advice here, right? So let's take it away, Expat Taffy.
What is this photo here? It is 6729, and according to NASA, it is taken with the same camera and taken directly after 6728, and they claim this is Mr. Bean standing in the footpad of the limb. But is it, folks? Is it? That's something we are going to take a look at. Because what we've got here, folks, is now the answer to a question I've been putting to all of these NASA numbskulls. How many astronauts were on the moon for Apollo 12? And they said two. So, let's see if they know what they're talking about, shall we? Let's take a closer look at this Mr. so-called Alan Bean at the footpad of the LEM. Now, folks, what I've done for you here, I've cropped the astronaut for 6729 and the previous one, 6728. And we are going to do a comparison. Now, just remember, there's another astronaut at this scene, Mr. Pete Conrad, taking these photos. He's supposed to be out on the moon somewhere taking these photos. So we're going to do a little comparison for these two last photos, shall we? And what you'll find is they are entirely different. They're not the same astronaut at all. It's two different stuffed dummy astronauts photographed elsewhere and copied onto the LEM. Let's take a close look at it, shall we? Now, folks, what I've done here is cropped half the astronaut and their packs. Now, the one on the left is the one you just seen standing in the footpad, 6729. The one on the right is supposed to be Mr. Bean that we followed down the ladder, 6728. And what I've done, because he was sloping on the ladder, I've slightly lined him up, made him vertical to look the same as the one on the left, so we can do easy, clear comparisons. Well, as you can see, the one on the left, in the footpad, he's definitely got an aerial, and quite a long one. Mr. Bean, off the ladder, as you can see, he's got no aerial. And he's only come down off the ladder into the footpad. Next thing, look at the top, second lot of arrows down I've got, the height. The one on the left, his helmet is higher than his pack. The Mr. Bean that was on the ladder, the helmet is level with the top of the pack. That's another difference. Now look at the third arrow down. The one on the left has got a black and white clip in the pack. Mr. Bean has come off the ladder. He's not got that clip on the right. As you can see, the clip is missing. Now here's the important part I told you we're going to be watching. Mr. Bean on the right with that black square. Take a good look at it. And the astronaut that was in the footpad, it's not full black. It's like an arrow. It's just showing the edge of the square. And underneath that, if you examine it, you'll find there's a black spot. Now, zooming that spot right up, it turns out to be a letter C. But on Mr. Bean on the right, under that black square, there is no spot at all. These are not the same astronauts, folks. So what you've got in Apollo 12 is three astronauts on the moon.
Now, can you see the problem here, friends? You have astronaut number one, which is 6729. Then you have astronaut number two, which is 6728. Then you got astronaut number three, which is 46-67-16. Now, don't you see there's a problem here, friends? Because this guy here is all lit up right there now. All right, now see, he's all lit up too now. And he's in the dark. Now, just hang on a second, because I got to show you something real neat here, all right? See that? What do you call this here, right? Right there. Now, that's what I call an arrow. And then we come over here, and this is supposed to be the same astronaut, by the way. And there's a square, and that square is all filled in. And blood. When we come down over here to 6716, guess what? Over here, now the astronaut's all dark, eh? And it's some different astronaut. Not this guy here, it's not this guy here, and it's not this guy down here. So this, where it is, here's this astronaut over here. Where the hell did he come from? You see what I mean there, friends? We have three astronauts for Apollo 12. Now, that's pretty bad, isn't it there, eh? But if you think that's good, ooh, just wait till you see the next one I got for you, because this one here is going to rock your world, isn't it there, you crazy slack ass and mysterious mystery and our whole rest of your screwy, crewy crowd there, eh? So let's just see what we can dig up on you on this one here. So let's have a look at that one, please.
So, folks, coming back to this photo here, look what you can see left and right. You can see the reflection of the ground below. But what about the center? Now that is supposed to be the door into the limb. And what can you see in there? It's completely black. You can't see any reflection of what's inside the limb, which you should be able to if the limb was lit up. So according to this, there is no light in that limb whatsoever. And this is supposed to be taken by Mr. Alan Bean from inside the limb. So how could he take a photo of Pete Conrad on the ladder from a limb that's in total darkness? Another thing that's impossible, folks.
Now, friends, what I'd like to do here is I'd like to show you two photos. This one up here, which is 6716, and the other one, which is down right there, which is 6729. Now, don't you see that we have a problem here? And the problem is that, you see over here, you see now, that limb over here, which is this one right down there, is actually in the shade. Now, there's no sun there, is there, there, friends, eh? No sun whatsoever. But when you look at this one down here on 6729, what do you see here? Oh, my dear God, the whole stage set right over there inside of the hatch. Oh, it's all lit up again. Oh, man, now that's pretty bad, isn't it there, eh? Now, how can the sun not be shiny here? See, it's all dark, and then look at this one down here. Oh, it's all lit up again now, isn't it there, friends? Oh, I've seen everything now, eh? So, let's just have a look at this here crater and some of these objects down here, all right there? So, take it away, Expat Taffy.
Now, the next thing I'd like to know with this photo 6724 is, who dug out the crater under the limb? Now this is the only mission, Apollo 12, that shows a crater under the engine bell. But it wasn't created by any blast from any rocket engine. It was created manually with a shovel. Because as you can see, all the dirt from the inside of the crater is just pushed to one side. It hasn't been pushed more than a foot away from the crater. Definitely not from any engine blast, folks. So who dug that out? Now, folks, here's the best view of that crater, although it's from a photo, a couple of photos on, which is 6729. There's a crater, clear as day, and you can see the soil dumped by using a shovel, dumped to one side. It hasn't been scattered everywhere by the blast from any rocket engine. And what we'd like to know is, who threw a few metal objects into that crater and another metal object in front of it? What we've got here is a stage setup in the studio where the ones making the photo, the stagehands, have tossed some unwanted items under the limb, hoping nobody would see them. Or would they have been put there by whistleblowers? But they wouldn't have been there from them landing on the moon, and the only thing happening was Mr. Pete Conrad coming down the ladder. More evidence of fakery, folks, that this photo was not taken on the moon.
Well, thank you very much for that discourse, Expat Taffy. We sure learned an awful lot, didn't we? And you can certainly see that that is indeed a crater. Whoa, that's a real deep crater too now, isn't it there, friends? And that's the only crater that you'll ever see in any Apollo mission. Wow, something's real wrong here, isn't there now? Because, see, those Chinese went and landed that, what, J-Rabbit there on the moon there, right? And underneath their lander, there's no crater whatsoever. But then we come over to this here, and we see there's a big crater there. Now, the only way this here crater could have been dug is with some dude with a shovel. Hey, I was just wondering, perhaps it's one of Expat Tavi's dummies that he found in another photograph that held a rake, and perhaps in his other hand he had a shovel to shovel out all this shit out of this here crater, dump it all over here and over there and over there here, you see? Oh, certainly. And another question, too, is how did all these metal objects, I mean, they look like rings from pipes or something like that. Now, don't they, friends? Hey, look at this other one down here. How'd all that shit get over there, eh? Who dumped it there, eh? What happened there, eh? Was the Santa Claus end up stopping by on the moon there? And old Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer had an extra package on his horns? Oh, that's about the size of it now, isn't it there, friends? Because this is all lies. And right over here, you know what that is now, eh? All this here area and all this here area over there is what you call the industrial waste dump. The infamous industrial waste dump. Isn't that right there, friends? So, it's time to play. Drum roll, please. It's time to play Spot That Anomaly. Yes, it is, friends. It's time to play Spot That Anomaly. Now, the anomaly in this photograph could be the shadow down here, or it could be the flag over here, or it could even be this here limb over there. Now, it could be anything. Could even be that little dotted thingy down there, or it could even be the ladder. It depends on what you see. Now, winner is going to be receiving $20 US worth of Bitcoin in cash. So you better get your Bitcoin account in order so that we can send you the money if you win. In order to win, you need to be a subscriber of ours to the Peter Piper channel, the channel that gets rid of all NASA dumpsters and sends them packing right back to where they came from. It certainly does. So, the winner will be announced in the next video, and the payout will be within 24 hours. And it is in U.S. funds, and it will go to the winner. So, it's better get on your thinking caps there, and the subscribers will also be the pans too. Doesn't matter. As long as you can spot the anomaly in this today's photograph, that means the first person gets the cash. And whoever doesn't win will end up, the cash prize will end up going into the pot, which means that the pot doubles every 2 weeks now, doesn't it there, friends? So you just better get your thinking caps on and we'll see what happens here. Right there, friends? Okay. So that's my spiel and that's the end of this video for today. You guys all have a great day out there. And to all the dudes that are sending us the viruses, well, you know what you can do with them viruses now, don't you? So dear friends, that's our spiel for today. Mr. Strange out.